Charisma Media presents Is the End Near? Written by Michael Youssef. Narrated by Bob Sauer. To all my ministry partners around the world, without whom this ministry would not be possible. Foreword. Of all Dr. Michael Youssef's many books, I feel singularly honored to be asked to write the foreword to this one. It is right up my street, and there is no subject that grips me more, challenges me more, and gives me more hope. The answer to the question, "Is the end near?" is yes. If you have any doubts about this, get ready to receive information that will not only convince you, but sober you to your fingertips. At the same time, this book will equip you not to be afraid. There is so much to look forward to, and you won't have to wait long. There is a lot coming down the road that is not pleasant. This includes persecution as our nation has not seen. But such persecution elevates us to a higher level, approaching what the great saints of old experienced. Why should you and I be exempt? Our being shoved out of our comfort zones is long overdue, and the result will be joy and victory beyond anything we could have dreamed. Beginning with the helpful analogy of a woman in labor pains just before the arrival of her baby, Dr. Youssef demonstrates that today we are in that very moment. This helps you and me understand what is going on at the present time. We are right in the middle of that painful time when we await God's stepping in, which He does in the nick of time. For example, Dr. Youssef shows 6 labor pains from Matthew chapter 24. These are unfolded and applied so clearly and helpfully. This kind of clarity continues throughout the book. This book provides the most practical and relevant application of Matthew chapter 24 I have ever read. There is more. This book is filled with vital information, not just Dr. Youssef's theological convictions, but scientific facts, relevant knowledge. With his wide and careful research, Dr. Youssef has gifted us with helpful information that shows he is in touch with what is going on in the world. I have learned things that I hardly expected from this kind of book. A further subsidiary fallout of this book could be that Christians will be stirred to pray like never before, so much so that it could lead to great revival just before the end. R.T. Kendall. Chapter 1. Is this the end? Increasingly, people both within and outside the church are asking the same question. Is this the end of the world? Christians phrase it differently, of course. Are we in the end time? But both Christians and non-Christians are watching current events and coming to the same conclusion. History appears to be drawing to a culmination. In July 2021, The Nation published a story titled, "The End of the World is Closer Than It Seems." In that piece, author Tom Engelhart wrote that he worries the world will end in a nuclear holocaust. Even as a pandemic killed millions in 2020, 9 nations, he points out, were growing their nuclear arsenals. More than half of the expenditures for new nuclear weaponry, $37.4 billion, were laid out by the United States, including $13.3 billion for the development of intercontinental ballistic missiles. In total, the 9 nuclear-armed nations spent about $137,000 per minute to update a global nuclear arsenal that, Engelhart writes, could end history as we know it. That same month, in The Telegraph of Great Britain, columnist Janet Daly wrote, "Is this the end of the world? Every time I turn on the television news, I am confronted by an apocalyptic panorama of fire, flood, and never-ending plague." Though Daly didn't believe the world would end in fire, flood, or plague, she worried that a frightened humanity might be stampeded into accepting an authoritarianism that presents itself as benign, but inevitably proves to be tyrannical. If you have read the Bible prophecies of the Antichrist, you know what this authoritarianism would look like. Also in 2021, the Chicago Maroon, the independent student newspaper of the University of Chicago, published a story titled, "Is This the End of the World?" in which authors Malutin Jaja and Laura Grassoni trace the origin of the Doomsday Clock, a warning symbol of global catastrophe. The clock was created in 1947 by the scientists who helped develop the first atomic weapons in World War II. Their publication, the Bulletin of the Atomic Scientists, has shown the doomsday clock on the cover of every issue. The clock, housed at the University of Chicago's Harris School of Public Policy, illustrates the scientists' assessment of the extinction threat to humanity. On the doomsday clock, midnight symbolizes ultimate doom, the end of humanity. The first cover of the Bulletin of the Atomic Scientists in 1947 showed the clock's hands at 7 minutes to midnight. Over the years, those hands have sometimes moved closer to midnight and sometimes farther away, based on the assessment of experts. The clock moved to 2 minutes before midnight in 1953 after the development of the hydrogen bomb, and swung to 17 minutes before midnight at the end of the Cold War in 1991. Giorgia and Gersoni listed numerous threats to humanity: a global pandemic, wildfires, hurricanes, climate change, and even swarms of locusts of biblical proportions that decimated crops in East Africa. These disasters seem to explode at the beginning of the 2020s. As I write these words, the doomsday clock displays a sobering 100 seconds to humanity's midnight. In the estimation of these experts, the threat to humanity has never been greater than it is right now. In the coming pages, we're going to look at some of the horrors and catastrophes that threaten the human race, and that Jesus told us would come upon the world before his return. If you are an unbeliever and you are looking realistically at the state of the world right now, I honestly don't know how you can sleep at night. But if you are a genuine follower of Christ, you can face the future without fear. You don't need to cower under your bed because God is in control of this world, and He is in control of your life. The book you are listening to is not intended to frighten you, but to encourage you, give you hope, and magnify your joy. It is Almighty God, not the atomic scientists, who holds the future in His hands. His timetable never moves forward or backward with changing events. In His Word, God has given us a reliable and reassuring guide to the future. Jesus has told us what to expect in the days before His return, and He has told us not to be anxious or afraid. Wars and rumors of wars. What events did Jesus foretell? As we are about to hear, He prophesied that false messiahs would come, deceiving many. Wars and rumors of wars would spread around the globe. Nations, political rulers, and ethnic groups would rise up against one another. Famines would decimate populations, and earthquakes would shake the earth. Jesus foretold all these horrors, and they are coming to pass as I write these words. In the decades since the end of the Cold War, people have become complacent, assuming that it was unthinkable that one nation would invade another nation, as Nazi Germany invaded Poland, France, and other nations in World War II. Then, on February 24, 2022, after amassing a force of 190,000 troops along the Ukrainian border, Russia brazenly attacked Ukraine, bent on slaughtering civilians and swallowing up the entire country. This act of unprovoked aggression ordered by Russian dictator Vladimir Putin triggered the largest European refugee crisis since World War II, displacing nearly 7 million people, about one-sixth of the Ukrainian population. Russian atrocities against the Ukrainian people included the indiscriminate slaughter of civilians, acts of rape and pillaging by Russian soldiers, and the deliberate targeting of a bomb shelter in Mariupol that was clearly marked "children." 300 Ukrainian civilians, including many children, died in the attack. A viral video from Ukraine shows a little girl with a message scrawled on her bare back. As bombs and artillery shells rained down upon this child's neighborhood, her tearful mother took a marker and wrote the child's name and birthdate, along with the phone numbers of her parents, on her back. Many Ukrainian mothers and fathers have had to prepare for the unthinkable, the very real possibility that they and their children might be separated or killed as war engulfs their country. Inflation, scarcity, and famine. Even before the war in Ukraine, the world economy was staggering from the effects of more than 2 years of the COVID-19 pandemic. The pandemic had scrambled the supply chain, bankrupted businesses, and fueled uncontrolled inflation. In 2020, David M. Beasley, executive director of the UN's World Food Program, predicted that the pandemic would cause famines of biblical proportions in more than 30 developing countries. "This is truly more than just a pandemic," Beasley said. "It is creating a hunger pandemic. This is a humanitarian and food catastrophe." What Beasley didn't know and could not have foreseen was that the food catastrophe of 2020 would be made many times worse by the Ukraine war in 2022. Russia's invasion of Ukraine prompted the United States and Europe to boycott Russian oil, gas, grain, seafood, and other exports. War-torn Ukraine, once the world's largest wheat exporter, stopped shipping its harvest, resulting in abrupt food shortages around the world. The global boycott of exports from Russia and its ally Belarus had a devastating impact on global food production. Before the war, Russia and Belarus supplied much of the world's agricultural fertilizer needs, including more than 40% of the world's agricultural potash, 22% of the world's agricultural ammonia, 14% of the world's urea, and 14% of the world's monoammonium phosphate. These fertilizers are essential to growing corn, soy, rice, and wheat. From Canada to Brazil, from Africa to China, growers faced shortages of essential soil nutrients, and populations faced famine. In just 1 month following the Russian invasion of Ukraine, global wheat prices climbed 21%, barley prices 33%, and fertilizer prices 40%. Tony Will, CEO of American fertilizer producer CF Industries, told Reuters, "My concern at the moment is actually one of a food crisis on a global basis." The UN's Beasley said Russia's invasion of Ukraine has only compounded a catastrophe on top of a catastrophe. There is no precedent even close to this since World War II. And U.S. President Joe Biden warned, "It's going to be real. The price of the sanctions is not just imposed upon Russia. It's imposed upon an awful lot of countries as well, including European countries and our country as well." Jesus told us that before his return, we would witness wars and famines. These crises are coming upon the world right now. They are already devastating the world economy and the lives of countless people around the world. A bag with holes in it. The Lord has warned that out of control.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.